In this video, the topic which I am going to cover is, what does a transportation problem mean and an example transportation problem in order to find the minimum transportation cost by applying the northwest corner rule. First of all, to start with, what does a transportation problem deals with? A transportation problem deals with the transportation of a commodity from M source to N destination. It's assumed that the level of supply at each source and the amount of demand at each destination and the unit transportation cost of commodity from each source to each destination are known. It's also assumed that the cost of transportation is linear. In order to have a better understanding of the above statement, I'll give you a real life example. Consider a company which manufactures three items like pen, pencil and eraser. The company have distributor at two places. One is at Chennai and another one is at UP. Suddenly, one day an order came from Delhi. The company does not have any distributor at Delhi. In this case, the company have to transfer their goods either from Chennai to Delhi or from UP to Delhi. In this situation, the company will take distance into consideration. The distance from Chennai to Delhi is quite long as compared to the distance from UP to Delhi. Therefore, the company will dispatch their goods from UP to Delhi. Therefore, the example which I have given, in which distance is taken as one of the important components which will decide the minimum transportation cost. The overall objective of the transportation problem is to determine the amount to be shifted from each source to each destination such that the total transportation cost is minimum. Here is the mathematical representation of the transportation problem. Xij refers to the amount supplied for transferring and Cij is the cost of transportation. This linear programming formulation is also known as a transportation problem. Here is a note point which need to be taken into consideration while solving the transportation problem. The two sets of constraints will be consistent if summation of Ai is equal to summation of Bj. Summation of Ai is the total supply and summation of Bj is the total demand. A total supply must be equal to the total demand, which is the important condition for a transportation problem to have a feasible solution. Problems satisfying this condition are called as a balanced transportation problem. If this condition is not met, then the transportation problem is said to be unbalanced transportation problem. Definition 1 tells that a set of non-negative values xij, I equal to 1, 2, 3 until m, j equal to 1, 2, 3 until n that satisfy the constraints is called a feasible solution to the transportation problem. Definition 2 is that a feasible solution to a transportation problem that contains no more than m plus n minus 1 non-negative allocations is called a basic feasible solution to the transportation problem. Here, m specify the number of rows and n specify the number of columns. Definition 3 is that a basic feasible solution to a transportation problem is said to be a non-degenerate basic feasible solution if it contains exactly m plus n minus 1 non-negative allocations in independent positions. Definition 4 is that a basic feasible solution that contains less than m plus n minus 1 non-negative allocation is said to be a degenerate basic feasible solution. And definition 5 is that a feasible solution is said to be an optimal solution if it minimizes the total transportation cost. Therefore, the main concept of the transportation problem is to obtain the minimum transportation cost for transferring the goods from one source to one destination. Here is an example problem where we are going to find the minimum transportation cost by applying the northwest corner rule. Supply is given as 4, 8 and 9. Demand is given as 3, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Each small box is called as a cell and the value within the cell is called as a CIJ. CIJ is a cost of transportation for transferring the goods from M source to N destination. First, we need to check whether our problem is balanced or not. The sum of supply is 21 and the sum of demand is also 21. Since summation of AI is equal to summation of BJ, hence our given problem is balanced. Always we need to take the 1,1 cell. The supply along our 1,1 cell is 4 and the demand along our 1,1 cell is 3. Since our demand has been completely met, therefore we strike that entire column. And 4 minus of 3, which is equal to 1, which we enter along our supply, and 3 minus of 3 is 0, which we enter along our demand. Again, we need to see our 1,1 cell, which is 11. The supply along our 1,1 cell is 1 and the demand along our 1,1 cell is 3. Since our demand has been not completely met, so we strike the entire row, that is along the supply. And 1 minus of 1 is 0 and 3 minus of 1 is 2, which we enter along the demand. Again, we need to check our 1,1 cell, which is 4. The supply along our 1,1 cell is 8 and the demand along our 1,1 cell is 2. Since our demand has been completely met, therefore we strike that entire column. And 8 minus of 2 is 6, which we enter along the supply, and 2 minus of 2 is 0, which we enter along the demand. Again, we need to check our 1,1 cell, which is 7. Here, supply along our 1,1 cell is 6 and the demand along our 1,1 cell is 4. Since our demand has been completely met, therefore, we strike that entire column. And 6 minus of 4 is 2, which we enter along our supply, and 4 minus of 4 is 0, which we enter along our demand. Again, we need to see our 1,1 cell, which is 2. The supply along our 1,1 cell is 2 and the demand along our 1,1 cell is 5. Since our demand has been not completely met, so therefore we strike the row, that is along the supply. And 2 minus of 2 is 0, which we enter along the supply, and 5 minus of 2 is 3, which we enter along the demand. Again, we need to see our 1,1 cell, which is 8. The supply along our 1,1 cell is 9 and the demand along our 1,1 cell is 3. Since our demand has been completely met, therefore we strike that entire column. And 9 minus of 3 is 6, which we enter along the supply, and 3 minus of 3 is 0, which we enter along the demand. Again, we need to see our 1,1 cell, which is 12. Here, supply is also 6 and demand is also 6. The supply and demand value must be the same in last step. In case if it is different, then we have made a mistake somewhere in between of our cell. So here, our supply is also 6 and our demand is also 6. So we strike the both and make it as zero along the supply and along the demand and enter that sex in the center of the cell. Now we have to reconstruct our entire block and we have to make our allocation to the corresponding cell. The number of allocation we have got is 7 and the number of row is 3, number of column is 5. So 3 plus 5 which is equal to 8 and 8 minus of 1 is 7. So the number of allocation which we got is less than or equal to number of row plus number of column minus 1. The solution is non-degenerate and the optimal basic feasible cost is obtained by multiplying the Cij with the respective allocation, which is equal to 2 into 3 plus 11 into 1 plus 4 into 2 plus 7 into 4 plus 2 into 2 plus 8 into 3 plus 12 into 6, which is equal to 153. Therefore, 153 is our minimum transportation cost for transferring the commodity from M source to N destination. Thank you for watching this video.